for many U.S. forces who have fought alongside the mostly Kurdish Syrian Democratic Forces in northern Syria and now feel like they are abandoning their brothers and sisters in arms. It's been hard for the families, too. One U.S. military spouse has written an open letter to the Kurds, and CNN is protecting her identity because her spouse is still active duty. In it, she writes this: "Dear Kurdish soldiers, you don't know me, but I have known of you most of my adult life. When my military husband and I quickly married, knowing he was deploying to the Middle East to be part of the 2003 invasion of Iraq, I feared what he and his special operations unit would face when they arrived. How bad would the fighting be? How long would they be gone? Would he survive? And months later, he returned and recounted to me what he could about his experience, and I asked how he had made it through. He replied, 'We had help. We had the Kurds.' He told me stories of how the Kurdish people in northern Iraq supported the troops, advised them, stood by them, fought shoulder to shoulder with them in combat, and became an ally and a friend. And I became grateful, immensely, unwaveringly, and forever grateful for you. Since then, the word Kurds in my home has meant something. It has meant ally and friendship. There are pictures of Iraqi Kurds alongside my husband and fellow soldiers in our home. I have a coffee mug with depictions of female Syrian Kurdish soldiers on it that I proudly use to remind me of you. My children play soccer in their Kurdistan jerseys. The Kurdish people are not nameless, faceless people across the world. You hold a place of honor and respect in our home. It's important to me that all of you know that. I owe you so much. My husband is home, safe today after years of fighting, and I know you helped make that happen. But now I watch the news in horror. I see promises broken, progress destroyed, years of hard work and unimaginable sacrifice gone in a tweet. I see allies betrayed, their faces in my picture frame. While watching the news, my children turn to me and ask if those are our friends, and I say yes. They have looks of confusion on their faces. I can't imagine what your families are going through. I can't imagine their fear. I can't imagine these things because for the last 17 years, you have fought to help us keep an attack off our soil, and I know that has now compromised your safety. It breaks my heart," she says. And she goes on to say, "I write you today on behalf of my family to say thank you for everything you have done for us. Thank you for your friendship, for keeping your word and fighting alongside us, for staying the course year after year. Thank you for keeping my husband safe so he could come back home to me and my children. You have my sincerest prayers today that you too may safely return to yours. Thank you to your families that sacrificed without you so you can make this partnership happen. I pray we return to your side, that we stand by you, and this has not all been in vain. Forever yours, a grateful wife."